The Senate confirmation hearings for Supreme Court nominee Brett Kavanaugh begin tomorrow. Lawmakers on Capitol Hill preparing for a fight, especially now after the White House decided to withhold 100,000 pages of Kavanaugh's records. Joining us now live and local with a preview of these hearings, Dr. Dave Duilio, political science professor at Oakland University. Dave, thank you so much for joining us here this morning. We knew this confirmation was going to have a lot of tenacity going into it anyway. Now with all these pages being withheld based on what's being called presidential privilege, it certainly gives the appearance of trying to conceal important information. Could that possibly be true?
Well, anything's possible when it comes to Washington, D.C., and I think you're right that it has that optic of, hey, what are they trying to keep from us? Democrats in the Senate have long sought all of the papers from Kavanaugh's background. His decisions are easy to get, but those when he worked in the Bush White House, those are subject to executive privilege.
Now, realistically, even if all the Democrats were to vote against this nomination, is there really anything the Democrats can do to prevent it from happening?
For the Democrats to stop this confirmation, they would need to stick together and all vote against and convince two Republicans to come over to their side. Those two that are being mentioned most are two female senators from the GOP, one from Maine and one from Alaska, and they have both indicated so far that they're going to support him. Both Susan Collins from Maine, Lisa Murkowski from Alaska, appear to have sent some signals that they're going to vote for him. So it's going to be really difficult for Democrats to stop it, and that might, and they may even lose some of their own members from states where Trump won big in 2016, and where Democrats are up for re-election this year. One of the chief ones, West Virginia, Joe Manchin, he may end up supporting Kavanaugh as well.
So, do you really think there is this Trump fear factor that's affecting oh so many politicians?
I don't think it's a Trump fear factor. I think it's a voter fear factor. Democrats that are up for re-election in states that Trump won tend to be more conservative than many of their colleagues. And that's because they're reflecting the constituents in their state. Joe Manchin is a much more, on many issues anyway, a moderate Democrat compared to, say, somebody like Kamala Harris from California or Cory Booker from New Jersey. And what they're doing is simply reflecting their constituents' views, and they will feel the pressure to vote for a conservative Supreme Court nominee.
These next 2 months, Dave, are going to be very interesting with the nomination hearings and, of course, the midterms about 2 months from now. We appreciate your time, your expertise. There's no doubt we'll be talking to you many times again in the coming months. Thanks for joining us.
Sure thing. Thanks.
WWJ News Time, 11.